they always said I'm wrong. But what they doing today? I think they want me gone, but I ain't going away. They told me I was wrong, but look at my ass.
Yo guys, what's going on? I'm Tim for the NFL Final Score on the Real Sports Talk Network. Thank you for tuning into the 4:15 edition. If you didn't see the 1 o'clock edition, click right here because you get to see Justin's rant on his Chargers. Yes, I'm wearing a Chargers jersey because I'm too pissed at my Eagles, who I did a rant on in that video as well. So you're going to want to go check that out. Again, click right there and you can go watch that video. 4:15, there are only two games. It is the last bye week, so there are only two games in the 4:15 games this weekend. They were the Raiders and the Chiefs, and then the Giants and the Cowboys. One game was rather uneventful, and the other game was an extremely fun game to watch. We'll start with the Raiders and Chiefs. The Raiders do come out in this one 26-16. Carson Palmer throws for two touchdowns. Darren McFadden rushes for 114 yards. And Jamaal Charles in the running game for the Chiefs are not able to really get much started. They fall in this one. Brady Quinn, who had been named the starter coming into this week, last one series before getting injured. Apparently they were checking him for a head injury. He goes out with a head injury, and Matt Castle comes back in and gives his usual mediocre at best performance, throws for like 200 yards, really does not do much in this game. So again, Romeo Crennel is screwed with quarterbacks for the second job that he's had as head coach. The first one was the Cleveland Browns, and the second one, ironically, Brady Quinn is one of the very average quarterbacks he has, much like how it was in Cleveland. Second game was the Giants and the Cowboys. Early on, the Giants absolutely dominated this one. They get up 23-0 on a few Lawrence Tynes field goals. He had a huge game today, a Brown run, and a Jason Pierre-Paul interception that turned into a pick six. By the half, though, the Cowboys were able to cut this to a 23-10 lead. Romo ran one in, or in the third quarter, I should say, Romo runs one in, and he threw another one in to make it a 24-23 Cowboys lead. You felt like they were in a good situation, but at the same time, you look over and you see the fact that, Eli Manning's coming back out on the field. Eli Manning comes out, leads them to a drive to begin the fourth quarter where Lawrence Tynes hits another field goal, and he ends up hitting a second one. The Cowboys get the ball back down 29-24. I'm watching this game, and they get close to the end zone, but nothing really happens. They're not able to score. Tony Romo on the fourth down play drops back, throws his fourth interception of the game. This one really was a meaningless interception. He throws his fourth interception of the game. And at that point, there are about a minute, 2 minutes left. I just turned it off. What ends up happening is the Giants do a poor job with clock management. Eli Manning and the Giants get stopped on a third down run. So it was actually Ahmad Bradshaw that made the run. They get stopped. They punt it away. Tony Romo gets them back into position to get a touchdown. He throws one deep to the end zone, to the back of the end zone, to Dez Bryant, who makes the catch. But on a review, it ends up that his hand went down first, out of bounds. It was pretty obvious that it was out of bounds. Tony Romo and the Cowboys are not able to score on the remaining two possessions the remaining two attempts they get. And the Cowboys end up falling. The Giants go to 6-2. I think what you can take out of this game is that the Giants certainly are not unbeatable, but the Cowboys, I think it's really overrated, how clutch Eli Manning is. If people talk about it during this game, Eli Manning's had a lot of games where he's earned people talking about him being clutch. This would not be one of them. He did what any other quarterback's going to do. He put them into position to have Lawrence Tynes or whoever your kicker would be kick a field goal that would give you the lead and then add a few insurance points on. But he didn't do anything special late in this game. Tony Romo played pretty well in the fourth quarter. I mean, I know he had that late interception, but really that was one where he had no protection on that one. The Giants defensive line burst through Jason Pierre-Paul, Justin Tuck, and he was flushed out of the pocket. He wouldn't have even made the throw if it wasn't fourth down. He does that, and it was a meaningless interception. I'm not saying he played well, because his interceptions got them in a hole early on. He ends up with four picks in the game, but I really think it's sometimes overblown how unclutch Tony Romo is, because I think in this one, he put them in a position to win. Dez Bryant had the ball, and unfortunately, the way things go, it's a game of inches, and Dez Bryant's hand was that extra inch that cost the Dallas Cowboys this game. Great NFL weekend, and tonight we have a chance for the Giants to clinch the World Series. If the Giants do clinch the World Series tonight and Hurricane Sandy has not put my power out, I will be on tonight discussing the Giants as world champions. If not, then we'll wait and see what happens. Again, if I'm not on here and the Giants do win, it's because the hurricane has knocked my power out. We're out of southeast Pennsylvania, so at some point the hurricane will probably hit around here. Hopefully everyone on the East Coast is safe, is taking the right precautions. Hope everything goes well with everyone. I'll see
just a little bit around the corner from fear. Be there by next year. Where I'm going.